Salwanani, greetings. Welcome to the Girls Table Talk Show, a show that gives young women from marginalized areas a platform to share their experiences on issues that affect them. Well, today we want to talk about period poverty in marginalized communities. Ngeke ngabona ama headlines that speaks to Zimbabwean girls are resorting to cow dung for sanitary wear. Sifuna ukuzama ukuzwisisa ukuthi how far true is this? Young women ba affecte kanjani ngendaba ye period poverty. And joining me is Tavi, so she will introduce herself as it ukuthi uvela ngapi, and I have two young women from Lamtree and Cholocho labo bazazicho amabizo abo. Over to you.
Okay, thank you so much, baby. My name is Tabiso Sibanda. I work with an organization called She Decides, which is an organization that looks at issues to do with the rights of women in terms of health and sexual reproductive health, and how young women basically can, you know, ensure that they have got rights towards their bodies, what they want to do with their bodies, in terms of family planning, in terms of menstrual health and hygiene, and so forth.
Hello, Salvonani. Mna ibizo lami nguSandra Matanleya, velela ePlumtree eMangwe. Ngidila ku-organization ye-Girls Table, whereby sifundiswa kakhulu ngokuziphatha kwenkazana, lokuhlolisisa kwabomamanyana ukuthi siphila kanjani.
Salibonani, ibizo lami nginguPrincess Ndlovu, ngivelela eCholocho kuward 6 eBhangamakoni. Lami ngi-part of i-Girls Table, ngivelela eCholocho, lami ngizokhulumisana kabanzi ngendaba ye-period poverty ukuthi is-affecta njani ama-young women from Cholocho. Sizabonisana la njengama-Girls Table labanye nje abaphakathi kwendawo.
Cela ukubuza Thabiso, are there any laws that speak to menstrual hygiene? Angazi ukuthi ngathi imithetho kumbe yini, but anything that speaks to menstrual hygiene, as in laws.
Okay, so basically mina ngiyangithanda ukuthi ngithi menstrual health and hygiene, the health component makes it ukuthi issues around menstruation fit into the basic right of the right to health, which is a constitutional provision. So first of all, if we are going to talk about the laws, we are going to talk about constitutional provision of the right to health. So now, because a woman, it's not just the basic health, you to child kanda and stuff, there are a lot of things. The most important component of e-health, yabo mama, is the reproductive health, whereby in menstruation, we know that there is no reproduction without menstruation. So that's where it fits in. So, and then there are also maybe policies here and there that also speak to it. Ama policies like the reproductive health policy. And then amongst ama adolescents and young people, especially the school going age, we have the school health policy. We also have the adolescents and young people's sexual reproductive health strategy, which speaks to issues around access to menstrual health and hygiene, information, commodities, and basically.
Thank you, Tavi. So, to the young women, what's your understanding ngasikhuluma nge-period poverty? What comes to your mind when someone says period poverty?
Okay, i-period poverty ikuswelakala kwendingakalo ezinjengama-pads ma umuntu ongumamethe wangena esikhathini. Kwenzakala uswelakale ama-pads, and kube lesizathu sokuthi uwaswele ngayiphi indlela, ngoba sometimes kubuya from ama-backgrounds, abantu as-afford okufana nayo. So kuyabe sokufuna ukuthi mina ngendlela engi-understand ngakhona, ngi-understand ukuthi kumele sincediswe njengama-young women, kumele sincediswe ngendlela ezijiyeneyo ukuthi lathi sincedise abanye ukuthi bethole lawo ma-pads.
Princess, what's your take?
Okay, mina according to my own point of understanding, ngicabanga ukuthi ma ukhulunywa nge-period poverty kahle kahle, as a young woman, there is a stage yokuthi umuntu angene ku-period and kube nendingeko eziningi ezifana lama-pads. So ukuswelakala kwama-pads yikho okungaba ukuswelakala kwama-pads, izinto nje ezingani ongazisebenzisa for i-period yakho. Ngicabanga ukuthi yiyo ma ukhulunywa nge-period poverty, ukuswelakala kwendingeko zama-pads.
Thank you. Thank you, Soro Kata. Tabiso, do you have anything to add? And bemfuna ukubuza futhi ukuthi nxa sikhuluma nge-period poverty, because I read somewhere ukuthi it's not just about ukuswelakala kwe menstruation products, but the issue of amanzi. Ukuthi khona kuyana, so ngifuna ukuzama ukuzwisisa ukuthi when we talk of period poverty, what exactly are we talking about?
Okay, so the text of definition of period poverty is lack of access to commodities. But it's not only limited to lack of access to our commodities and menstrual hygiene. Like you are rightfully saying, Uguti, there are issues to do with water and sanitation, which are seen as social determinants of health. Remember, we say menstrual health and hygiene is a health issue. So it's not just lack of ama pads or pela, while it's they form a very integral component, but also ukuswelakala kwe sanitation services, ukuswelakala kwe ama bathroom or ama washrooms, ayavumela ukuthi umuntu nxa uperiod yakhe akwanise ukuthi they can self clean and they can, you know, manage their period is also part of it. And also ukuswelakala kwe information is also part of period poverty. Ukuswelakala kwe information regarding menstrual health, ukuswelakala kwe information ukuthi how are you supposed to manage your period, and also the information around the people around you, because you're also supposed to have a support system. That's also a part of a period poverty, as well as the other issue is issues around religious and cultural beliefs. They also form a component of a period poverty. Ukuthi sina lapha sisuka khona, you know, there are certain beliefs like ukuthi umuntu maybe nxa ku period they are unclean and so forth and so forth. Those issues bring about stigma and discrimination. So where there's stigma and discrimination as well, you can attribute to it having a period poverty.
I didn't know about the issue of religion. Kona ke ukuthi ke thi nxa usesikhathi namalanga nje hlala ungabuyi elokuzeni, but well, we are learning. What are the causes of a period poverty kuma areas that you guys come from? Remember, usukhulumela omunye umuntu ongale khaya ole problem ye period poverty. So kubangelwa kuyini ukuthi kube le period poverty amongst young women?
Mina ngibona ngathi lapha emvela khona mostly girls abanye bale pride khona kuyani ukuthi umuntu ethole esesaba ukuthi ekhulume ukuthi sengu period kumbe etshele ehluleka khona ukutshela uanti wakhe ukuthi sengu period khona kana uanti uyabe ngakwazi kukanti umntwana uyaswela so kugcina lakho kumhlukumeza lwana umntwana eqiniswela indinge kuzeni ziyana.
Okay, on my own side ngapha lapho ngivelela khona etsholo joma ngikhangela kakhulu i-period poverty. Ama causes akhona mostly in my community bayaswela as in terms of imali. So mabeswela abalayo imali yokuthi bethenga labantwana ama-pads. And ngendingeko zabo the first priority efikayo emqondweni yabo ukuthenga ukudla. Uma bethola ukudla then ama-pads are not part of the list value ukuthi umntwana wenkazana kumele ethengele ama-pads. Ngakho bacabanga ukuthi nje umntwana wenkazana nje kumele azibonele umbuko othenga udinga amalembu sebenzisa amalembu basebenziseni ngoba imali they value it for ukudla mostly.
No, besides I understand ngekuthi wena ngikhetha ukulamba over ukuthi umntana nami ahlale egqoke i-pad. It's an issue of ama priorities really. Ngicela ukubuza ukuthi so ukhulume ngamalembu. I've seen headlines akhuluma ngokuthi some of you are resorting to using i-cow dung. Khona enye ngibonile ukuthi people are using isata. So what else are you guys using nxa lingasela ama-pads, or yini eliyenzayo ukuthi wenze sure ukuthi ngiyawathola kumbe ama-pads wona lawo or nxa ungalawo instead of amalembu? What else are you guys using?
Thina so far into esengiyinanzelele ukuthi sokulama-organizations adila labantwana kakhulu abamankazana, and those organizations they are donating ama-pads esikolo kuma-primary schools from grade 5 to grade 7 then from kuma-secondary schools. Yikho into esiyenzakala ngale ukuthi umntwana engazizwa eswela then bafaka ama-responsible persons kulawo ma-schools abazabe bebona ukuthi umntwana lo every month babanikeza ama-pads.
That's wonderful. Over to you, madam.
Okay. Tinagiti, for now, abantu basebenzisa makuyukuthi kumbe umuntu kalawa amaphedzi bekuyisikhathi sokuthi basebenzise amalembu bokungakabi khona ama programs afana la ukuthi angakwanisa ukuthi ayincedise abantwana ukuthi bekwazi ukuthola amaphedzi abaswelayo so bekuba affecta kakhulu in terms of ukuthi uma umntwana sisebenzisa ilembu kakho comfortable in terms of abanye ngabantwana besikolo umuntu ethe maybe ngiform form 2 uyaqala ukungena ku period of which uyaleya lose i confidence kase isikolo wasakwansi u concentrate end up kasaya esikolo so into e affect kakhulu abantu esigabeni sakithi
Thabiso is someone who probably works with young women, yeah. Someone who does sexual reproductive health rights education. Ngicela ukubuza ukuthi what are your findings so far ebantwini elisebenza labo ukuthi bayenzana nxa sezithola ukuthi they cannot afford ama pads, they do not have access to menstrual products. Bagcina besenzana, what is it that they do, what is it that they use instead of ukuthi umuntu asebenzise ama pads ngoba engawatholanga.
I don't think it's anything different from what the young ladies have said. It's mostly, especially within marginalized or rural communities, they resort to using amalembu na lawana, and well, I've heard reports about them using cow dung and izinto eziningi really. So and then lately there have been also programs ezifundisa the young ladies ukuthi benze ama reusable pads. I think it's a good initiative, although I always have reservations. Kathesu ngakhangela ukuthi sike problem yamanzi, you know. People have challenges even getting amanzi okupheka. What more amanzi okuwatcha ama pads, you know, ama reusable pads. So whilst I feel ukuthi it's a way of moving away from unhygienic means of managing the period, there is more that needs to be done, honestly. And I feel ukuthi every other girl has to have access to ama disposable pads just for those moments where they have challenges with the water and so forth.
Thank you. Princess ukhuluma ngokuthi bona echolojo, they don't know about these organizations okhuluma ngawo asefundisa abantu ukuyenza ama reusable pads. How can we get the information? How can we get these organizations to come to ama areas afana labo cholocho abathi thina ngisebenzisa ilembu? Angila ndlela yokuthi si reach out to these organizations. So sibathola njani? How do we reach out to them, especially for these young women othi thina we don't know about this?
Unfortunately, with organizations, sometimes when someone, it's normally those programs funding the grant whereby they put ukuthi they have specific target areas, so it becomes unfortunate to those areas that are not targeted ukuthi what can be done. Although I feel ukuthi there are certain community platforms that can be used, maybe Google Health Center committees or through the health facilities to try and do work around advocacy. We need even someone who comes and teaches us how to do it, or those small community-based organizations, there are small grants, USAID and so forth, that people, our self-help grants that people can apply for. I think we information in a lay, how can those community-based organizations apply for those grants after this mama and amantana betune ama reusable pads?
Thank you. I hope Princess utholile information ukuthi labo as young people from Cholocho abathi thina we don't have access to such information, and it's unfortunate Cholocho le network ayikho. Yeah, it's unfortunate ukuthi le network ayikho. But what is the impact of a period poverty? Kuyini okugcina kusenzakala esindebele esinzima sometimes nxa usutshintshe esikhiweni uhambise esindebeleni, but kuyini okugcina kusenzakala nxa umuntu ezithola engela ama pads, be it school going kids, thina as young women, kuyini esiqina sikwenza ngenxa yokuthi sichaywe period poverty?
Uthola umntana esikolo sefila uncomfortable, engasekho comfortable njengabanye abantwana, sefila out of place, and most of the times uyathola umntana vele engasalaleli lasesikolo, esezibona esehlulukelwe kakhulu kwabanye abantwana. And futhi thina njengabo mama nyana uthola sungena kwezinye indawo like uthole la usuyi sex worker at the end ufuna nje imali ukuthi uthole imali imali ukuthi uthenga ama pets because ukuba sex worker it doesn't mean you work at night uhamba njani njani but khona kyan ukuthi uhambe la uye lala lozibani uphindulale lozibani uphindulale lozibani just because you want that money ukuthi la uthole ama pets
na ngendlela engibona ngayo abantu abaningi amakazana amaningi acina asezibona engasafani lamanye amakazana because ukuthola kuyachiyana uthola ukuthi abanye bayathola amaphezi abanye abathole laba bangatholanga abasathu bazibona ngathi abasakwalify ukuba part of labana abantu especially into eziningi ezidinga ukuthi abantu labana kumbe sikhubalele isikolo noma bengakuqamba bethi you can go and illustrate this boarding awusakwazi ukusukuma so kumele ukuthi uqale uzibuze ukuthi ngi-right njani so kusiba nzima la ukuthi uconcentrate you lose i-self confidence ukuthi awusakwazi la ukuthi nje wenzeni phakathi kwabantu and the other thing ngiyavumelana nalo sisi ukuthi into enye elandelayo ugcina usukhomba awula mali the only way ukuthi uthole imali ukuthi ukhombe and the time ukhomba yena engakunika imali ukuthi uthenge amaphezi but on the other hand like he's looking for something kumele benefit something from when may say benefit something teenage pregnancy that's the way he is affected ngakhona
okunye abantwana bagcina belove esikolo so bamisa ama lessons amaningi kakhulu esikolo ikho okungabe kus affect thina as young women nge period poverty
I think if there's something that I picked out indaba yokuthi khona you get uncomfortable nxa uku period I remember mina la ngesikhathi sami ngathi even ngise classini ngiyahlala ndlala nxa usukumamela utheke isitulo sami ukuthi angistay nanga yini so kuya kuphambanisa generally kuma studies akho awusabi comfortable ukuthi usukume lawe uye presenter and do these other things because yeah, we say about what if usukume kanti ngistay nile we talked about these young women using amalembu sakhuluma ngendaba yokuthi sometimes amanzi ayahlupa sakhuluma even ngokuthi ukhulume ngokuthi amanzi ayahlupa even sesikhuluma ngama reusable pads ukuthi uyakwani sokube liwatcha yini okho since ka told li one suli watcha uzuligqoke lingakawomi so what are the health implications associated with using ama rags or cow dung for as a sanitary way
Okay so ama using ama means or ama commodities that are not that are unsanitary during the period akhozela imkhuhlane that can be called reproductive tract infections you know whereby ukuthi uyathola ukuthi ukusebenzisa cow dung and then it causes ukuthi umuntu abe lama infections within the reproductive tract uthola ukuthi umuntu sesiba lama rashes lama labo thrush kuma genitals as well and those diseases eziba khona ama infections abakhona ku reproductive tract they also contribute to some of the reproductive organs agcina siba lama cancers and so forth so really it does affect e-health it has a health implication you find out even lama pelvic infections they also come from using an hygienic commodities even lone pad ngokwalo that's why kule timeline ukuthi you can't use one pad the whole day but sometimes because there's that period poverty uzathola ukuthi umuntu maybe they have to use maybe 4 or 5 pads per cycle maybe they use one pad the whole day whereas you are supposed to probably change it maybe after 6 hours or so you find ukuthi period poverty really does contribute to ama infections that girls get even ama yeast and so forth some of them are caused by you know using those because ama reproductive organs are very delicate organs so you need to ensure ukuthi there is a lot of hygiene that takes place especially when you're on your period to make sure ukuthi you have enough water to wash to keep yourself clean and you're also using ama commodities that are very sanitary
so whenever a question that comes to my mind ukuthi kulabanye bethu were saying mina angenzi heavy flow so as long as ngingahlala lalo noma ngiyabe ngingakayenzi heavy flow ngingahlala lalo more than 6 hours kuyabe sokuwrong vele.
I can't really say that, but ideally it's just as good as a toothbrush, beke. Ukuthi dentist will recommend ukuthi every after 3 months you need to change. It's a health check. You need to be able to change your toothbrush. But how many people change their toothbrushes? So honestly, omnye umuntu uzakhangela ukuthi okay fine, I don't really have a heavy flow. But konkani ukuthi it's not just about the flow as well. You're putting on something, you sweat and everything. So you really need ukuthi 6 to 8 hours, you just have to change. But there are people who don't change. That's why I acknowledge that. And there are people who also even use tissues and so forth. But you find with the tissue learner, when it's now exposed to that dampness, you know, those small particles that can also get inside and also be a cause of some of these infections that we're talking about. So ideally, it would be nice with 6, maybe at maximum 8 hours, you should be able to change your pad. Wash, you have a clean wash, and you put on a new pad.
I'm learning new things. I'm learning new things because in a slow period, you paid la maliga twice. So, I'm learning a lot. 24 hours, 12 hours, looking the fagil. Nyapunda is interesting. I think there is need to invest in sexual reproductive health rights education because zineng is interesting. I zazio ngama reproductive to what productive is key was a summit. But uguneng is in a wazi ogumele si gufundiso. But njengabantu who are from marginalized areas, the city tina abazali nxa sengithe mina ngifuna imali yamapads bahlala phansi bakhangela ukuthi kathi sokushota impupho ngcono siyethenga impupho instead ukuthi siyothenga ini amapads. Licabanga ukuthi kumele kwenziweni from your communities, licabanga ukuthi yini okumele kwenziwe ukuze lidilele issue ye period poverty. And mind you, in your answer sikhulume la ngamanzi ukuthi i-period poverty ayikhulumi ngokuthi awula ama-products e-menstruation kuphela, but the issue of water as well. La ufuna ukugeza, uhlala uklini, uzize uklini, ufuna la ukuba confident nxa uku-period. So senzeni ukuthi sidilele period poverty and everything around i-period poverty.
Mina ngicabanga ukuthi singayenza ama-groups as ama-girls. Senze ama-groups, sihambe maybe sicela ama donations ama 1 pet umuntu maybe ikunikeza iphedeli 1 unikeza iphedeli 1 sithathe zonke siyabuthelele 1 ndawo. Then after that siko sesithi madoda wonke umuntu uyazazi ukuthi ungena nini kuma periods. So uma ukwazi ukuthi usungena u period, just go to a certain person ofika uthatha ama pets ozafuna ukuwasebenzisa.
I think kuma answers enu, as we were talking, likhulume ngepride. Imagine, because silayo i-period poverty, siyasebenzisa amalembu, but no one wants to come out and say, mina ngisebenzisa ilembu. So, laphana nxa sesihambile sadinga, sacela ebantwini. Do you think kubeke uzaba lasi sibindini sokuthi lese yagcinwa nguwe? Because asithembani as people, senzabe lokhu embuya, sendraba kithi, sokunje. Nge pride esilayo, do you think that's going to work? Or sizawagcina siwabuthelele, agcine esetshenziswa ngulowo yedwa owagcinileyo or a few people around that person?
Embona kusinika ipride thina ukuthi as long into yethu ingaba involved umuntwini omdala kakhulu kulathi, yikho lapho esingaba le pride khona. But as thina singama-youth, we can do that. As ama-young ladies, we can do that. Sikwazi ukuthi hayi madoda idate yami le, sibone lathi ukuthi senza njani ukuthi sincedisane.
So I think for us as organizations, from a policy angle, the work that we are doing, we are trying to lobby policy makers. Remember, there are provisions ukuthi there should be scraping of taxes ngasikhangele ama products, ama menstrual products, ukuthi even if they are being imported, they're supposed to be some scraping of taxes and so forth. So this is supposed to make sure ukuthi it reduces as well the pricing yama sanitary pads so that they can be affordable to most of the girls. So as organizations, we have done that work towards lobbying ukuthi kube le scraping of taxes, although really the implementation of it is not quite impressive because if you go to ama retailers, you find ukuthi they're still expensive. We're also doing work around ensuring ukuthi there is provision of free
sanitary way, ukuthi there should be a component of, I don't know, whatever tax that can be used, or domestic financing, just like we do have free condoms. You'll find ukuthi free condoms, of course, we get them because we also get donations from USAID and the Global Fund. But I think we should also move towards domestic financing, ukuthi whatever, maybe we have, we use the Syntex, we use the airtime levy or whatever it is, but we have a dedicated fund that is going to make sure ukuthi there's procurement of sanitary products that can be distributed, especially kuma marginalized communities through structures like the schools and the clinics and so forth and so forth, so that we make sure ukuthi there's access, as well as we are not really limiting the menstrual health commodities. There are menstrual cups, which actually work well. I can't really say better, but it depends, because you can use a menstrual cup for more than 5 years. You don't have to buy anything, you know, after that. You just use the menstrual cup, so it's long lasting. So the idea is to make sure that girls have got choices and options. If someone says, I can't use a menstrual cup, they should be able to use a pad, or they should be able to use a tampon, and so forth and so forth. It should really be at the discretion of the girl. Ugutimina, what do I want to use? We want to have as many choices, as many options as we can have.
To the young women, I understand ukuthi kulama kulezinto ozikhulumileyo elizenzayo ukuthi sidile le issue ye period poverty. But eyokuqala ukhulume ngokuthi ukuscrape ama taxes kuma menstruation products. So ngifuna ukuzwisisa from you girls ukuthi is the issue about imali ukuthi ayadura i period poverty, or ama families that are not prioritizing lokhu zenama menstruation products ukuthi basitshela ukuthi hayi iphedi uzasebenzisa ilembu, or yikuthi ayadura? Yikho engifuna ukuzama ukuzwisisa ukuthi is it about the price, or khona kuyana nje ukuthi sesatshela ukuthi hayi thina sakhula sisebenzisa amalembu laba abasebenzisa amalembu.
Ngibona ngathi ayadura ngoba as usisekhulumile ekhuluma wazwani ki-example ukuthi ama-condoms they are publicized. So why can those pads also be publicized? Like endaweni ezinjengabo sibhedlela, like kuma corner shops, ukuthi anyone can take. Ngibona ngathi ayadura because not everyone can afford. And ale idola oyitholayo, uthola ukuthi anyeke ugijime ukuyethenga i-pad, you better use ilembu udle kulokuthi ulambe usebenzisa i-pad.
Nxa ele dola bacabanga kangcono ngiyethenga isinkwa kulokuthi ngiyethenga i-pad, khona bama-pad akhona uyabe ukwazi ukuthi ngawomuntu oyi-one, but isinkwa sesikhava sonke, ayisimi ngedwa. Princess, wena uthini? Is it the issue of i-price, kumbe yikuthi vele lathi sesathi hayi amalembu akhona, okhawudang bakhona basebenzisa okhawudang?
Yes, to a lesser extent singathi it's a issue of imali. Angithi abanye babengelamali ukuthi sometimes ama price akhona adura, aba afford. But on the other hand, vele emakhaya lapha sikhuluma ukuthi I'm from Cholocho, semakhaya. There abantu vele bawuthatha as a tradition ukuthi we use amalembu. And ama pads esitolo kwalutshwana ukuthi uyethola umuntu ethi athenga ipad esitolo. Mostly bathengisa grocery, uthukela, uthola umpuphu, ama-pads, one store uzothola ukuthengisa khona ama-pads. Of which abantu abakho common ukuthi ama-pads yinto sibile ku-demand edinga ukuthi abantwana bamakazana bawasebenzise.
So anjabona abantu futhi ababuyi abafuni ukubuya kini emakhaya kakhulu. So line selikwazile ukubuya la. Yini sokumele lisukume liyefundisa abanye bena ukuthi guys ukungasebenzisa iphedi kuyasiphambanisa. So tell your parents ukuthi mama ukungangithengela iphedi kuyangi-affecta so kuma-reproductive health in. Because ngiyaku-understanda vele nxa usithi sesize seze ngasathengiswa eshopu. That's because umuntu uyabona ukuthi akula business kuma-pads. But well, do you guys have any questions for our guest speaker? Sifuna ukusuka lapha sikwazi ngendaba zabo period poverty, anything to do with menstruation.
Sister, mina ngizwe ukhuluma kakhulu ngama, bathini ama cups?
Menstruation cups.
kahle kahle sifuna ukuthi sicela nike lisitshengise wona njengathi sihlale emakhaya endaweni ezingathi zigcwele kakhulu abantwana abavela from emakhaya sicelane ngelinye ilanga lathi ukuthi libuye lizositshengisa kuyalani kanti ukuthi libuye lisuke from flowerayo lathi sikwazi ukuthi lizositshengisa lezo zinto ezinjalo kunje somunye umntwana ungambuza ngetampuni akalazi yaba ngathi uqambe esinye isitshebo angakaze sidle yabona so siyacela ukuthi kube lelaleyani awareness yokuthi sibili abantwana bazofundisa for special my girls especially from a primary level ngoba we don't know anything about those things
mina ngenje
ithabu ngiyeba ngiyalazi but some of us are afraid because I remember school I would hear people say ungasebenzisa i-tampon liyaku-breach-kivitinity kule story eziningi around izinto lezi esizisebenzisayo kuma-pads but please explain about ama-menstruation cups and how they work
so ama-menstrual cup unfortunately Yeah, I thought of carrying it with me, but then I don't know what happened. So that maybe you can have a visual idea. So I'm a menstrual cups. We have a company called the Butterfly Cup in Zimbabwe. It's a United States of America based company, but it's here in Zimbabwe in Harare that does work around a menstrual cup. So ordinarily for a working class person like you, you would have to buy a menstrual cup. It's $10. But if it's $10 and you're also counting which you can use this thing over years for more than 5 years, think of how much you save on buying a pad. But for the girls in marginalized communities, I remember when they were launching the program around 2017, 2018, they really were reaching out to marginalized communities. And for those, they give for free. And there are also organizations like I'm not really sure about Plumtree and Cholocho, but I know Gutebulawayo. There was an organization called Chieta that was doing a work around distributing menstrual health commodities. So you'll find that there will be a package that has got a cup, pads, painkillers, you name it, whatever it is that could be deemed as a package for menstrual health and hygiene management. So I know they were doing work around Gubo Pumelela Youth Center and the other one in Kuluma Esizinda. Those are the ones that I know of. So the program was around integration of HIV and AIDS programming and SRHR. So you'll find out when you're getting the packages, you're also getting condoms, you're also getting information on HIV and AIDS, you're also getting HIV testing services, that is if you need them. The specific cup, it works, there are certain different sizes of the cup, depending also on your comfortability as well. That you use, I think, it should be there's 5 mils and then there's 10 mils. So the idea is, you know, sometimes we think of what to make the bleed out, you know, bleed because it remains. But honestly, if you have to quantify that a day, it might not be more than 10 mils necessarily. So the cup you insert it, and then it's you're a where the menstruation is taking place, and then you know it collects that blood. So it depends. There are a lot of people who have reservations because they're like, hey, I can't stand seeing my period blood in a cup or whatever. But then it's a matter of options and choices as well. So you use that cup, and then you pull it off. Then you clean your cup. It doesn't need a lot of water. It's a silicone cup, so it's a material that is friendly to the body, really. And then you clean it. You can clean it with water and vinegar, or just very hot water, or a little bit of salt, whatever it is. And then you can reuse the cup. So the idea, there are a lot of speculations, really, and Uguti, you know, when you're not a virgin and so forth and so forth. But honestly, I feel Uguti, like I said, Uguti, it's a matter of options and choices. Uguti, mina, ninje, I am not comfortable with the tampon, then I probably will stick to pads. But there's someone who can use a cup. And you know, Uguti, when you're with your cup, you can do your usual sports, you can go swimming and things like that. Yeah.
We don't know much about it, so we just want to know, because the Panama mover, how do you feel?
I think you feel things that you put in your mind. What there's something, and then that's when you feel it. Because the idea, honestly, is we can't have a product that's not comfortable. I think if you just totally remove, it's just like even a pet. Sometimes, if you're too conscious about it, you can even, if you're going to wear jeans, you might even be worried, or maybe lit dindila or something like that. But I think the idea behind having those commodities, obviously, it was designed with an element of it to be adaptable to the body and for it to be comfortable.
I remember ngesikhathi ngiqala ukungena ku period ngangiqoka amapenta ethu because ngiyabe ngifila ngani and ngiyabe ngifuna ipenta elibambayo ukuthi ngifile sibili ukuthi iphedi leli alisoze lingenzela izitayela sengihambe kwantweni. Yeah, issue ye period poverty inzima. There is a lot that we need to learn. There is a lot that we don't know. But I'm here imagining myself with a cup. I can't.
Mila, I want to ask, still on that point, your cup. So that cup, does it affect your virginity or something?
Obviously, if you have your hymen intact, I think, I can't really say it can affect, but I think you might have difficulties using it. You might have difficulties probably inserting it. So I think from that angle, you might, if you have, you know, your hymen intact and stuff like that, I think you might encounter difficulties with. I don't know. What information do you have on using tampons? Do virgins use tampons? Because it's not like it's this amazing thing. It's just a small cup, really. So I think, of course, when you have the hymen intact, it might really cause difficulties. But then if you actually use tampons, you might find it easier to use amapads. Sometimes it's not even about the virginity. You find Wuti, like what Princess was saying, Wuti, you're conscious of who to forget something, so the comfortability, it's as good as the tampon, because it's a very tiny thing, Andy. But I think sometimes we have reservations in inserting things there. But there are people who actually use it, who are virgins and so forth, because if virginity requires penetration during sexual intercourse and not necessary. So if, but then unfortunately, we have always bordered virginity around having an intact hymen. There are people who are born without a hymen, or there are people who lose it due to maybe various sporting activities. It doesn't stop the fact that they are a virgin. But then if you feel like, oh, maybe you're a sporty person, you love swimming, those are the best commodities that you can use without having your period interrupting on your day-to-day activities.
Okay. There is a woman that I saw on Twitter. I don't know whether that woman is Kenyan, but why a CIA a parliament egqoke something estainile ebonisa ukuthi stainile. I think that was her way of advocating or raising awareness about period poverty. But what are your thoughts on that? Ukuthi, is it a good thing to do? Because the issue of period poverty, it's not about us women. Kuphela, when you talked about the need for support, those around us, or around us, men sometimes. So, labo, we need them to support us. Yibo futhi abafake imithetho ukuthi bafake imithetho yokuthi kulabo beke who cannot afford ama period. So, what are your thoughts on someone showing up a parliament with a stained trousers?
There are levels of advocacy. You know, sometimes we do talk, but if you find umuntu as a sensor, you know, bringing that into, you know, action, I think it's a matter of ukuthi somebody hasn't been listening. I know that was a very uncomfortable scenario, and I'm sure ukuthi even the men around the parliament were uncomfortable. So this is like a loud scream to say, if it makes you uncomfortable to see me like that, what about Mina? You know, and the world is watching, and everyone in the streets is seeing what I've stained. So for me, it was a statement. to be honest. I know there are a lot of sentiments. People say, oh, people overdo things and stuff like that. But for me, it was really a statement. It made a lot of people uncomfortable. But the fact that it makes you uncomfortable, what about all the other girls who do not have access to commodities, who have to walk around Montesebo Peliche Sekolo and stuff like that? So if it makes you uncomfortable and you're not the one, what about me? So for me, I feel like it was really a loud statement on Uguti, we need to prioritize issues. And also, like you just said, Uguti, you know, most men are policymakers, and so they do not have an understanding. Sometimes they look at things and they think Uguti, it's petty because it does not necessarily affect them because they don't have a uterus, but they are governing our uteruses, you know? So I think sometimes it's really good once in a while to make them uncomfortable a little bit so that they say, okay, we don't want to see you with your stained stuff anymore, we are going to do something about it, you know. So it, for me, it really was, I looked at it on a positive outlook to say Uguti, at least someone is taking a stand. I remember even in our own parliament we have had a legislator who was talking about issues of secondhand undergarments. You know, they pose a health threat to women, and they went with a whole bag and they threw them at the parliament table. You know, sometimes it's not necessarily being extreme, but sometimes it's also a matter of Uguti, we have said things over and over again and somebody is not listening, and maybe sometimes a little bit of extremity will just bring you to the conscious fact Uguti, something needs to be done.
I've gained a lot, and I understand when you're saying, oh, Mama Luana, it was a loud statement. Uguti, says kulume sa kuluma alesizwe. Maybe ngagengi wuye liwono uguti gusi limaza njani, then it's important. And then one thing I picked up, uguti, there's a lot that we do not know about menstruation as young women. You know, there's a lot that we need to learn, especially the issue of uguti, ukufaka iphedu kumele kube lesikhathi olikhipha ngaso, thina siyabe sisebenzisa amalembu, how does it affect us? So there is need to invest in menstruation education for young women. You know, ukuthi abantu babekwazi ukuthi nxa ngisenza ukuthi kung-affecta njani. And then she talked about engaging our parents as well, ukuthi as much as imali ingekho, let's prioritize ukuthengela abantu abethu ama-menstruation products, because nxa ungasayithenganga ukhulume ngabo cervical cancer and everything. So imagine your child esegula ngenxa yokuthi wena uthe angilayo idola. To our policy makers, bakithi, isimo sibi. If something could be done ukuthi sidilele issue ye period poverty, some are saying why engabi free lawo njengama-condoms. But thank you, ladies. Thank you, ladies, for coming through. Thank you, ladies, for sharing your experiences with us about period poverty. I'm sure someone out there is listening. And even our organizations that do things to do with sexual reproductive health rights, there are some parts of the communities where there is need to go and conscientize people about the importance of using the right sanitary way. Thank you so much, Tabiso. We learned a lot and we are grateful. Uguti ubuye uzosifundisa menstruation cups. To our followers, thank you so much for tuning in. And if you loved our show, please do subscribe, like. From the Girls Table, siyabonga. If you want to follow us with the Girls Table, it's table_girls with Twitter, the.girlstable Instagram, and the Girls Table Facebook. Don't forget to follow us, like and subscribe. Thank you.